Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In our discussion of Android data persistence, so far we have covered file I/O and shared preferences. The next natural progression would be about the discussion of SQLite database. If you just do a brief search on what is SQLite, you will come across its official page. Some of the keywords that you hear about the SQLite are self-contained, in the sense it doesn't have any external dependencies for that particular SQLite database to work. It is just one single source code file using which the library has been created. And SQLite is serverless. Typically, what you see in most of the data systems is you have a separate machine and a server where the database application is running. That is not the case with the SQLite database. And also, there is zero configuration. You will not hear about the terms like library or the driver that you typically hear in most of the Java programming. No installation, no setup. You can just get started with the coding. SQLite satisfies the ACID properties of a database. This is very, very important from mobile application perspective, where there is always a chance of power failure, disk failure, and operating system crash. So SQLite is quiet, robust for the mobile app environment in which it will be used. And another important aspect is it is open source. If you have a look at the executive summary, another important aspect is it's a very small memory footprint. Keeping this aside, you might be wondering, where is the Android connection? Since the very beginning of Android, the very first version has been using the SQLite database. These are the various versions, that is 3.9 to 3.4, that have been part of the Android journey. If you are wondering where you can find this SQLite database as a part of your Android SDK, you have to look out for platform tools folder under the SDK. Under that, there will be a file called as SQLite 3. The 3 probably stands for the major version of the SQLite version. Using this SQLite 3 executable file, which is part of your SDK, you can create the database. It is better to have a look at it through a demo. So let us get into a demo. If you don't know where your SDK is, you can launch your Android Studio, go to Configure and SDK Manager. You will find the path to your SDK Manager. You have to go to Platform Tools folder under SDK. We will navigate to this particular folder structure through the command prompt. So let me open the terminal on the MacBook here. To create a database, what you have to write is SQLite 3 and the name of the database that you want to create. So in this case, I will write SQLite 3, then sample.db. You might be wondering why db. It is just a convention that I follow. There is no compulsion that it has to be a .db. You can create your own extension. As you can see, a new kind of prompt starts appearing. Let me get started by creating a table here. So let me create table author. The first column is ID. I want it to be an integer primary key. So integer primary key is the keyword that you need to use to create a primary key. And then I want another column, author name, and I want it to be text and not null. You just created a table and the database. You can even observe that a sample.db got created here. To check whether the table has been created or not, you can use .schema. It will show the contents of the database. To insert the values into the author, you can use insert into author. Then the primary key need not be given explicitly, because it will be automatically created and incremented by one value whenever you add a new content into the author table. So you can directly select author name, give values author name 1. It even doesn't tell you whether the insertion successfully happened or not. You can just check it. So select star from author. You can observe that insertion has happened. So let me add few more values for the demonstration purpose. And after this, I want to create another table called as book and want to associate the author with a book. So it's basically like a foreign key or a referential key constraint kind of behavior I want to show you guys. So let me create another table called book. It will also have a ID, which will be a primary key. And after that, you have to create another column, that is book name, and it will be a text, not null. And the third column should be the foreign key, which references the primary key of the author. So let me create fk underscore author, and it will be an integer. To associate the fk author to the
primary key of the author table, you have to write foreign key and use the column with which you want to create this foreign key association. Then use the keyword references and the table with which you want to do this association. So it would be author ID. So the table has got created. Let me add some values into the book table. Insert into book. And once again, I will select the book name and the foreign key values. Let me call it as book one, first book name. And the value is author one. That should do the insertion. Let me add another value here and let me check whether the insertion have happened. What if I try to add another book with the foreign key as 3? 3 doesn't exist in the author table and the insertion shouldn't happen, ideally speaking. No error, nothing. And if you try to check, you will observe that the 3 actually got inserted. You might be surprised to see this because the foreign key or referential integrity constraint has not been held. The reason being, by default, SQLite doesn't come with the foreign key enabled. You have to explicitly enable the foreign key. As you can see, the 4 and 5 values in the foreign key column are not present in the author table. To actually enable the foreign key, you have to use another command, that is pragma foreign keys, and you have to give a value as 1. This will basically enable the foreign key. And now if you try to insert the values into the book table with a non-existent foreign key value, you will get an error message. So let me try to do that and you will see an error, foreign key constraint failed. This is something that you have to be very aware while working with the SQLite. After having had a look at the SQLite demo, our main concern here from the Android perspective is how to create a SQLite database in the app, how to create the database and tables programmatically, what happens when the new app versions are pushed, how the versioning of the application is going to have the impact on the structure of the database. Most importantly, if I can put it in a nutshell, it's all about how do I go about this without messing it up. And that is what we will be discussing as a part of our next video. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.